Hi everybody, my name is Rhys Barber. I'm the audiologist here at Audiology Associates. We upload new earwax removal videos every Monday, Wednesday and Friday at 9 p.m. UK time, so please consider subscribing. Hey everybody, this is Rhys Barber from Audiology Associates. Thank you very much for watching our earwax removal compilation video today. So two patients in this compilation. This first patient's come through. They've basically just had a lot of reduced hearing, no pain or anything. But what we can see here is quite a large blockage of earwax deep in the canal, so roughly about halfway down the front end of this wax. So just very gently stripping this wax out with a standard size ulna tube here. So really just peeling away the outside edges. You can see it's a bit of an awkward shape for suction because the top portion of the wax, as you look at the screen there, is coming forwards or jutting forwards, not a nice solid shape to get a grip on. It's quite angular. So we're stripping away all the outside edges first to try and get a better grip on this wax, because it has firmly wedged itself half to two-thirds of the way down the ear canal. So you can see you've got lots of bits of dry skin here all around the outside edge of this wax. So we're trying to strip that away because it's going to be holding on to the wax and it interferes with the suction as well as we're suctioning in here. What we're doing when the wax is this deep is we need to try and sort of establish where the eardrum is as well. So you'll see me suctioning at the bottom of the canal there. What I'm doing is almost undercutting the wax slightly. So when I pull on the top section then, hopefully it'll help to pull that wax down and we can peel it away from the canal walls a little bit more effectively. Thanks to everyone who took part in the poll we put on our channel as well the other day, asking what you guys would like to be called, and the overwhelming majority came up with waxaholics. So that looks like the term we have to use to address anyone who loves watching wax videos. So still undercutting this wax at the moment. There, now we can just start to see the eardrum there. Okay, so that little blue circle you can see is the eardrum. So we know the kind of depth we're working with now as far as this wax is concerned. So now we've undercut that, we can start pulling down from the top. So we can see little gaps. You can start to see the eardrum now from behind this wax. I can see as we're suctioning this that the left hand side of wax is tucked behind a little bump in the canal, so that's going to prove a little bit more awkward to remove just because obviously trying to accommodate the tools in there. But you can see we're trying to strip away the right side. So what I'm going to try and do is get a grip on this piece, try not to touch the canal wall too much. You can see it's just all getting sucked in luckily and coming away in nice big chunks, so clearing all the way around, and just take this piece away at the top here. You really don't want to leave wax in that top portion of the canal above the hammer bone there. It's called the attic region. It can become quite problematic if wax is left there. You can see we're just lifting, there we are, the wax away. A little bit of wax here at the top of the canal, so I'm just going to try and get that away if we can. Not so worried about the lighter colored material to the right hand side, that's more newly formed wax. There you go, just taking bits of that away, bit of dry skin there. And there was the eardrum. Now this is the other side. So this is the same patient but the other ear. There was a little bit of wax in here, so we showed the patient what was going on in there. They asked if we could just remove this for them at the same time. This isn't causing any problems on this side, so the patient wasn't even aware they had any wax on this side, just because there is quite a large hole in the wax. So it means the sound can get through to stimulate the eardrum. So we're sticking with the standard size ulna tube here. Just working on the wax at the entrance to the canal first. It was jutting out quite a way at the entrance. And what you find with some of these pieces, the wax can be connected from the front end of the canal right the way to the back, which is what's happened here. So little bits of dry skin, drier bits of wax getting sucked in there. Okay, so now we're going to work on the deeper section of earwax now. So aiming for the bottom there. Because this is in a slight groove, if we can aim for the bottom, we might be able to lift it out there like that, you see. So we broke the seal at the bottom of the wax the canal wall, and then we took this big chunk away, little tiny bit there to the left hand side, so we'll hoover that up. There he goes, bit of tidying up. So you can see the eardrum there as well, looking nice and healthy. So this is what we removed from both sides. So lots of little smaller pieces compared to what we normally get out. That's it there in inches. So this is our second patient, the compilation. This patient obviously does have quite a lot of hair in the outer part of the ear canals, but quite large pieces of wax in here as well. So I thought it was a good one to put in for you guys. Obviously the first section here, you can have a little bit of hair obscuring the view, but as we get a bit deeper in, then you're going to see much larger pieces of wax. So this wax is darker in color, so that's going to indicate to me that it's a little bit older. And sometimes when you have very dark wax like this, it can also mean that the wax is a little bit drier. So what we get is a much stickier, more malleable, pliable type of wax. So very sticky. So as you try and pull this out, what's going to happen is this wax is going to start sticking to the canal walls on the way out of the canal. So what we're going to try and do is maneuver it around so that we unstick it from all the canal walls first, and then try and take this out in larger pieces. So you can see that's what we're doing at the moment. It's just trying to break this down. You can see it. We've got a bit of movement to the top, so we're concentrating our efforts there first. But can you see how sticky and kind of, it's almost like a crumbly stickiness. It's a really strange consistency, this type of wax. There you go. So you can see we're trying to lift from the base of the canal, because I can see there's quite a large, there we are, that large piece there was stuck holding this wax in. So we're just trying to lift that off the canal wall at the base of the canal there, so we can try and get a little bit of a wiggle to this wax. You can see it's starting to come away now in bigger pieces. So there we are. Perfect. Now, what I wanted to show you here is a retraction pocket. That's what the arrow's pointing to there. You know what I said on the video before, it's, you shouldn't really leave wax in this area. See, it's got slight a depression there. That part of the eardrum is sucked in a little bit more than the rest, so you end up with this little dent. Now, if you get wax and skin debris in there, and especially if somebody's prone to ear infections, that would be a precursor for possible cholesteatoma. Now that one looks nice and clear, so no issues there. If there was any wax in that area, we would clear that out, and you can see that's why we had to take that wax away on the other patient, because you don't know what's behind it, so you always got to check that area of the eardrum. So yeah, definitely worth looking at that one. Now this is the same patient but the second ear, so much drier wax on this side. So we're going to go in with a Jobson horn, looking for any gap in the wax. Sometimes you'll get a nice gap at the top, so closer to where the top portion of the ear canal there, to get behind it. No obvious gap here. So what we're doing with the Jobson is breaking a chunk at the front here, tidying up then with the Zollner tube. So suctioning all the smaller pieces of earwax into the tank here at the front. So just stretching, pulling this wax from side to side. There we are, just trying to unstick this from the canal wall. You can see there's a little bit of hair in here as well, which isn't helping because it's binding this dry wax together. Trying to lift it off the base of the canal because it's really stuck here. So if I can, you can see you get a little bit more, there, can you see a little bit more movement to the wax now? So a little bit of dry skin down there as well, which has been holding this in. Trying to maneuver that dry skin out, but now we've unstuck it. Let's try and get behind it now with a Jobson. Break a little bit more away. It's going back in now. You can see just how kind of it's that sticky, crumbly stuff again on this side, with a lot of hair matted into it as well, which doesn't make it easy to remove. So just taking away lots of, I do show you at the end what came out in this ear as well. See, now we've taken the center section, the top portion of the wax has come away, but this bottom section where it's been against the canal wall, the Jobson horn didn't dig into that. So we're using the Zollner tube just to tidy that up. You can see what, now we've broken it down, we're getting a lot more movement to the wax, much bigger pieces coming away. So while it's like this, we'll carry on using the Zollner tube. See, it's nicer for the patient because when you put a Jobson horn in, when you push down, the patient feels a little bit of pressure against the canal wall, so it can be a little bit uncomfortable. So not every patient likes the sensation of the Jobson horn. So you can see we've got a deep piece now. So same again, working at the bottom, unsticking it there first, lifting it. There we are, getting a little bit of movement. Piece sheared off, so we're just going back in. Quite a hard plug, this last bit. You can see that most people have this kind of little valley at the bottom, this pinching at the bottom of the canal there. So I'm just using the Jobson horn, the Zollner tube to hold on to this wax and try and maneuver it outwards. So lifting to try and unstick it there. Now we're starting to unstick. I can see the sheen of the eardrum as well underneath. Okay, so the bottom section's gone. We've just got to clear the top section now so we can see. I want to take a look at the attic region on this one as well, just because obviously the patient's got a retraction pocket on the other side. So it's definitely worth taking a look. There we are. So there's the eardrum. There's a little tiny bit of wax there just jutting out on the canal wall. So we'll just go and grab that. Not going to cause any problems, but we'll just get rid of it. So there's the retraction pocket on this side. So there is one, not as pronounced as the other side, but nice and clean, so that's good. And the eardrum looks lovely and healthy. So this is what we removed in centimeters. You can see there's up to about 7.5, maybe 8 centimeters there, and the same in inches, so 3 inches or just over. Thank you very much for watching our video today. If you did enjoy the video, then please like. If you're not subscribed already or you'd like to do so, you can click the subscribe button here. If you'd like to check out some more of our videos, they're also up there. Now, if you want to follow us, you can do on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and also check our website if you want to know a little bit more about us. And as always, guys, until the next time, take care.